Welcome back to Kickturn Party.
We're back again, and we're bringing you some of the finest in skateboard history that you'll ever see.
Aren't you lucky?
Yes, you are.
Obviously, we're minus one of our crewmen here. JD has to take care of his mom. So what we got on tap today, Jay?
So we're going to talk a little bit about, and we've had another episode about one of our good friends that passed away here recently in Knoxville. And so we're going to do a little bit more of a Fallen Heroes episode and commemorate one of our other friends that passed away
tribute.
A while back, a tribute to Blaize Blouin. It's a good guy, ripping skater, probably one of the smoothest, stylish skaters you've ever seen in your life. We've got some video of him, unseen video, never been
on the internet.
Never been on the internet. Heck, it's never been really anywhere.
Yep. Other
than the living rooms here in Knoxville.
Any of you guys out there in YouTube land that have knew Blaize, skated with Blaize, or were at some place that Blaize skated, the guy was incredible. I was a little bit younger, and the first time I saw Blaize, I mean, I had no idea who the guy was and why he was, but when he laid down a frontside rock and roll board slide across eight pool coping tiles, clack 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 clack.
Yeah,
man, the guy is a style master.
Yeah, he did that. He did that at the farm ramp in Raleigh.
That was polyurethane coated blocks. Yeah,
that thing was just immaculate. Crazy.
Anybody that went to the farm ramp jams back in Raleigh in the 80s, that was the 88 Halloween 88 contest.
Halloween 88.
And that was when they took the farm ramp and the barn ramp, put them together with an oververt pocket and a weird elevator hip that connected the two of them because the flats weren't the same.
Exactly.
And Blaize pretty much dominated that contest. Rob Taylor had a good showing at that contest.
Doug Walker ripped it. Yes, it was. Reese Simpson was there. Ben Schroeder.
Actually, I think might have took first place in amateur.
Yeah, those guys came from California and they tore it up. Yep. And they loved us because we showed up.
Keg of beer in the back.
I drove my truck down from Knoxville with a whole crew of us. And we had a keg of beer in the back. And so we pulled up and threw down the tailgate. And it was kind of like almost Spicoli-ish, you know. We didn't have a cloud of smoke rolling out of it.
But 2 days later, my mom showed up in a hippie van wearing Farrah Fawcett shorts. Yeah. And everybody in the place was like, who's that?
He broke his shoulder. And and we had to call his mom. He was, what were you, 13?
13 or 14, yeah.
And we had to call his mom to come get him. And she showed up looking like Farrah
Fawcett. Yeah, what really sucked, too, because I probably would have taken 1A that day. Yeah.
So let's... If our producer could cue up a little bit of that farm rent video of Blaize.
Yeah, there's Blaize. And that's the barn-farm combination at the Wainwright residence. And you guys might know Brian and Morris Wainwright. Brian Wainwright was a championship vertical roller skater.
Yes.
Look at that elevator. Look at that thing where those two ramps combine. Yeah. And that wall right there was polyurethane-coated pool block that you could 50-50 and board slide. Look at him, man. Yeah. Damn, Blaize.
One of the most stylish skaters that I've ever seen in my life, regard none. I mean,
frontside rock on the elevator.
On the weird hip thing.
Yeah.
Absolutely. This guy, he was a bit of a controversial guy, hanging out with friends, but as a skater, he was probably one of the most stylish guys I've ever seen.
You know, if you didn't know Blaize and you showed up at a scene with him, you might have thought he was a dick. But look at that, yeah. But he was actually just, I don't know if he was misunderstood or if he was just, that was just who Blaize was. But yeah, well, I always got along with him. I always thought he was
I always got along with him pretty well, too. I went on a couple of road trips with him. I went down to Florida with him.
He spent some time hanging out in Knoxville with us. I think it was one summer or fall.
Yeah.
He ended up hanging out, sleeping on some couches for a while.
Yeah, he lived there for a couple of 3 months.
Yeah.
Look at that. Oh, those, yeah.
Frontside foot plant.
Someone said the frontside foot plant, slop plant that he did. I can't remember who it was, said there was only three people that could do it right, and Blaize was one of them.
Well, and he did it fast plant style.
Yes.
You know, he did it booster fast plant style.
Yes. He was.
Sweeper the channel. Backstop. And notice every wall that he just did was a different trick.
And this is one of the reasons that people say Blaize is kind of a jerk. And you'll see
he would
it
run
right,
you off the ramp.
You'll see it right here in a second. He didn't take no guff. Someone dropped in on him. He was like, all right. And he, you know, And this guy was not quite as good a skater as Blaize, obviously. But Blaize made it a point to, like, you know.
Run him off the ramp.
Yeah, fully take him out. Not just run him off the ramp, but fully take him out.
And now he's got the ramp.
Yeah, and now he's got the ramp, and now now he can perform.
That was a great contest. The camp scene and hitting each campsite in the morning or in the evening was really rad.
There was a fireworks war. We almost, the entire contest almost got run out because they were going to call the cops because it just got too way out of hand.
Well, the first morning that I woke up with the broken shoulder, I remember crawling out of that tent that Adam brought and trying to find you guys and just hobbling from one campsite to the next. And every time I'd hit a campsite, whoever was there was like, oh man, you look like crap, have some food. Here, have a beer, you know, it was the first thing in the morning. I was a kid.
Well, when we showed up, they hadn't even completed the ramp.
Yep, they were still working on it. Yep. And we ended up going to Lynnhaven.
Yeah.
Not Lynnhaven.
Wilson
YMCA.
And that's where you Wilsoned.
Yeah, I Wilsoned at Wilson
on
that sheet metal half pipe doing a mute air.
And then we had to take him to the hospital, and that's a whole other story.
Blaize.
Yeah. So this is also, okay, so we'll continue on with our little video montage
here. This is Florida.
I took a little road trip with me and Blaize, Doug Walker, and Dan Ray.
Dan Ray, wow.
Yeah.
Walker.
Down to,
Slug Walker.
Down to Stone Edge. At the time, this was probably the only concrete skate park.
Yeah, one of the few concretes that still worked.
In the entire country.
Painted yellow lip.
Yeah, yeah. They had got rid of a couple of the features at Stone Edge. This peanut pool was incredibly hard to ride. Very tight.
Not for Blaize.
It was like ours here in the Knoxville Skate Park, but it was all vert.
Well, I was going to say, it looks like 5 foot transitions and 3 feet of vert.
It was gnarly. That thing was really gnarly to skate. It was a lot of fun.
What year was this?
88. The nine bowl.
So this is when Blaize is riding for GNS?
Correct. And I meant to bring a GNS board in here. This is about the time that he had just got a pro model. And it was right when vert was dying.
It was beginning to die.
Yeah. Blaize and Sean Miller, rest his soul, another good East Coast skater that ripped. I've got a Sean Miller board and I was meaning to bring it in so I could show the crazy concave that those guys had on those GNS boards, because those GNS boards had this really, really crazy concave.
You know who else was doing that in the late 80s was Zorlak. Was making weird, whatever their mold was, their press was making really weird concave. But it was all up front. It wasn't in the back. It was all at the front foot.
And that was Blaize. He was asking where he was. He said, I said, Blaize, what are you doing? He goes, I'm watching Monty and Older skate. Because Monty was skating the half pipe at the same time.
Ramp shaking.
Here we go. Well, let's hold on to that video for just a second. Another little known fact about Blaize was his sister Bonnie.
Oh, was top female pro in the late 80s, early 90s. Bonnie Blouin ripped.
Yeah.
And she was cool.
Totally cool. She hung out in Knoxville for a while. She used to work for Thrasher as well. She was really, really cool.
Was punker than most dude skaters.
Absolutely.
She'd kick your ass and then grind your face and then move on.
She was probably more punk than Blaize. Blaize was a bit of a hippie, but he was a cool
Bonnie
guy.
Bonnie was punk.
But Bonnie was pretty punk. So Blaize lived in Knoxville for a while. He did a little couch tour thing. So I've got a couple of stories about Blaize. You got any good stories about Blaize?
None that we haven't already talked about.
Blaize was... he was over at the house across the street from us one night, and there was a fish tank with a piranha in it. And for some reason, Blaize was trying to pin the piranha.
Hey, look, it's a piranha. Let's mess with it.
Yeah, he was trying to pin the piranha to the bottom of the tank with a chopstick, and he did succeed until the piranha came up and took a big chunk out of his finger.
He succeeded to pin. But he made the mistake of getting his hand in the water, in the tank.
And the piranha went, woof!
And the piranha came out and chunked his finger.
And he bled all over the place, and he was wondering why he was bleeding everywhere. And it was like, well, don't mess with a piranha, man. But Blaize, there was a lot of interesting stories about him. We took several road trips together. I wound up in a couple other crazy situations with Blaize a few times. But he was a good guy and a great skater.
And anybody out there watching that did 80s contest circuits or series with, when you, everybody stayed in the same hotel, I felt bad for whoever owned that hotel by the time it was done, and you weren't asked back.
Yeah, well, that was, yeah, there were some lawsuits and stuff. But so Blaze came and did a little
spiral
demo
back out there.
With
there
us.
You go, Jason. Yeah,
he came and did a little demo with us at a skate park we
this
had
was
here
our
in Knoxville.
First indoor
skate hut.
Yeah, skate hut.
And
first indoor park that
and
Knoxville
shout
had.
Out this right here is Tate Clair.
Yep, Tate ripped.
And I still keep in touch with him. He's
that's Rex.
Yep.
Rex Brown.
Yep. Rex Brown. There were a couple of kids that we had that were sponsored back then.
Rex and Daryl were brothers that ultimately could have gone on to be like Bones Brigade type pros and gave it up to sell crack on the street.
What's that?
No, we can't go into that today.
Yeah, we can talk about that. Doug Walker.
Doug. So this was actually my first job, was working at the skate hut when I was about 14. And Jay was my manager and used to make me do shit like clean the mold out of the refrigerator.
I did.
And I got
he didn't
paid,
do it well enough, and I made him do it again.
All I got paid was free skate time.
Yeah.
Yeah. And then I came and said, hey, Jay, I'm done with the refrigerator. Go clean it again. It's not clean enough.
And that was Ryan Wilburn, who also came out of Knoxville and went on to turn pro. This is
that's
Daryl. He was a ripper. I think he decided that he wanted to be a drug dealer instead of skateboarding.
No, he wanted to be a gangster, wanted to be a street corner gangster.
I wonder what happened to him.
Well, when our park opened, he actually came and paid us a visit at the park one day. He was, I think he was moving furniture or something for some moving company.
That was his brother.
It was Rex?
Yeah.
I thought it was Daryl.
Yeah, yeah.
And all I remember was heckling and saying, go get a skateboard and join us.
Yeah, yeah. And that's his brother,
Rex.
Right? Yeah, that's Rex right there.
They showed up at the half pipe in the backyard on BMX bikes, and we're like, you boys are crazy.
And they turned
and
in
turn into the best skaters in
some
town.
Some of the couple of the best skaters
There's
in Slug town.
Slug Walker.
And Doug Walker,
backs,
ripping it up.
Ollie, yep. Riding the wall.
So this was a little indoor warehouse we had for a couple of years in Knoxville. Very small, small place that helped launch Pluto Sports.
It launched Pluto.
And made it into the establishment and the multi-million dollar industry it is today.
Those of you out there that remember Batmite from the 80s, Schmidt Sticks Amateur, pretty much a top East Coast am for a long time, along with Doug Walker, Blaze, before Blaze went pro. But Pluto Skate Hut, that was Brian's child.
Oh, did you see that?
Still
on
exists
that
today.
Big,
yeah.
Huge invert on that,
on
little,
that little quarter bike.
On that little 5 foot ramp. Mm-hmm. That was ripping.
Yeah, that ramp was, what, 4 and 5 feet tall?
Yeah, it was 5 feet tall with a pool coping
on it. No, the half pipe was 4 and 5. Then that one
yeah,
was...
Yeah, did you see that transfer?
Yeah, that was a 5 foot tall quarter pipe with pool coping.
And there's Doug Walker again.
Doing
another river.
Oh,
yeah. He stalled it.
Did you see that? Look, look at the shoes he's wearing.
Yeah.
Vision Streetwear high tops.
See, and this was...
There's Blaze.
These guys are trying to emulate vert tricks on these little tiny quarter pipes,
yeah.
And they're ripping it up.
Backside ollie to tail. So yeah. Doug was an am for vision and goal wing for a long time, and he sported all the
And that's
the
Blaze
blurs,
right there.
The streetwear. Yeah, Blaze is ripping.
Yeah. Tate Clair.
Tate. Miller Flip.
Oh, Miller
transfer.
Flip transfer. Look at this stuff.
Whatever happened to Tate? You said you still keep up with him?
Yeah, he's,
What
he actually said he's going to be in Gallenberg next week and wants to snowboard.
What sucks is Brian was the proprietor of this place, but Brian could hold his own at this place with anybody else.
Yeah, yeah.
It's a shame that he wasn't out there riding too.
Well, you know, I think myself and Brian were probably running crowd control at the
time.
Well,
that's why I wasn't skating, because you guys had me doing lackey BS.
Yeah, well.
I didn't get to skate. I got to clean up stuff.
That's what you get. Because we had been skating with Blaze all week. Did you see him hit his helmet on the on the rafters on that?
Yeah, Doug.
Yeah.
Yeah, Blaze.
Blaze had the most stylish frontside rock and rolls. It was unbelievable.
He could frontside rock and roll anything like most other people can rock and roll.
Just unbelievable.
Stickers!
And we have sticker song.
Stickers!
There's Bart, rest his soul.
Yeah, Bart, another fallen hero. That was
Josh
and
Catherine.
Wow.
So
That was some good video.
That's a little trip down memory lane for here in Knoxville that you've never seen before. We're going to hold that video to the next. We've got some extra video. This is going to come up on the next episode. We'll be showing that here soon. So thanks for coming by Kickturn Party. That was a little bit about.
Thanks for watching. Yeah. Thanks for rolling down memory lane. Blaize, we miss you, brother.
Yeah, we miss you. Blaize, one of the most ripping guys from the East Coast. It's a shame he's not around anymore. And we're going to be bringing you some more great history of skateboarding from Knoxville.
More idiots talking about stupid shit.
More idiots talking about stupid stuff.
Everybody's going to hang out here tonight. All right. We'll pass out in the flat. All right. Nothing better to do than to take six runs, drink a dozen brews. Don't talk about anything else. We don't wanna know. We're dedicated to beers, both and brews.